There's no secret that Rafa Nadal likes the view from the top. Mount Tibidabo is the highest mountain in Barcelona. The breathtaking view gives the King of Clay time to soak up his big Masters win in Monte Carlo and contemplate the pursuit of the Barcelona Open crown.
It's true that this part of the season, Monte Carlo, Barcelona, Madrid, Rome, and then Roland Garros are, is the more most emotional part of the season for me. Here I play at home. It's a fact that I always enjoy playing in front of a Spanish crowd, so I'm very excited about it.
A win back in 2005 secured Nadal the first of 8 Barcelona Open trophies and a place in the top 10. 11 years later, he's ranked number 5 in the world and is still competing for the top prizes in the game.
He loves to come to Barcelona, and for us it's also, of course, very special. To have Rafa here is you have the idol of all the kids, and here in Spain, in Barcelona, Rafa is God. He loves the tournament, and he wants to play on clay more than hard courts. So that's why I think, and he won 8 times. So that's important for him.
Former French Open champion Albert Costa runs the Barcelona Open and is responsible for attracting the top players to his tournament. This year he signed defending champion Kei Nishikori, Frenchman Richard Gasquet, Nadal, and the second Spanish star in the top 10, David Ferrer.
The fighting spirit of David Ferrer is unbelievable. He can run for forever, so he's a fighter.
Spanish star Felix Mantilla won the Barcelona Open in 1999. He now coaches on the circuit and has watched Nadal and Ferrer succeed.
We don't really know how important they have been for Spanish tennis. And Rafa, for me, it's what he's done the last 10 years. And sometimes still getting criticized in the last year and a half. For me, it's something that's out of my mind. It's completely amazing. Whatever he's gonna do from now on, who cares? But what he has achieved, for me, it's just simply on our world.
Spain now has 14 men ranked in the ATP 100. That's more than any other country. And Tommy Robredo believes that having Spanish champions to look up to motivated his generation.
When we were young, we had a lot of players to look out. No, it was like Bruguera, Emilio, Moya, Correa. When you have someone to look at, and when you have a lot of clubs, when you have a lot of facilities for practice, a good weather to play nearly full time outside, these things help. No, and when you see a lot of tennis on TV, then it's the sport you want to practice. I think the tennis is changing a lot. Now there's a lot more powerful players. So for the Spanish players, it's tougher, no? Because we like to play longer points, and right now the points are going shorter and shorter, and that helps the rest of the world.
For now, this generation of Spanish stars has found a way to cope with the changing game. They still dominate the ATP 100 and have high hopes that one day they'll reclaim the trophy here at the Barcelona Open.